How's it going, everyone? Today we're going to take a look at how to strum and play some basic chords, looking at the song In Your Eyes by Jeffrey Gaines. It's a song I've never heard before, but it was a request by one of my students named John. So thanks, John. Hey, man. Hope you're doing all right. It's a pretty fun song to play. It's relatively easy, but it can be challenging because of the way Jeffrey Gaines embellishes his chords. So if you're looking to play it just like Jeffrey in the YouTube video, there's going to be some work if you've never done that before, done in chord embellishments, things like D, adding in the sus2, putting that sus4, several of the chords, have these embellishments, and it was fun to listen to and fun to play, so I'm excited to kind of get into it. So the first thing we'll do is go through every single chord, make sure we know how to play those. So we'll start with the Jeffrey Gaines version, and then we'll move on to the capo 7 supposedly easy chords, okay? So the Jeffrey Gaines starts with a B minor bar chord. So grabbing bar chords has a lot to do with behind the guitar, so let me turn like this and scoot backwards. So it looks like there's an angle, but the way that my thumb touches the back of the guitar in the camera, but there is no angle. My thumb is exactly perpendicular to the neck. So next is how low my thumb is. And the other factor is I'm really, my thumb is straight, but I'm actually pressing more on the side of my thumb, the back side. So that's really important. Another thing is keeping the shoulder and elbow, comfortably straight, and really curving the wrist out like that. Okay? If you do all of those behind the guitar things, it'll really help with any pain. You might still have pain, but it'll be good pain. It won't be nerve pain, or feeling like you just touched an electric fence. The B minor bar chord is based off of an A minor chord, which is the common chord we all know, but you use, instead of the pointer, middle finger, and third finger, you use the ring finger, pinky, and middle, and then you scoot it up 2 frets, and you bar the 2nd fret. I am also muting the low E string. And I'm being careful not to really strum the low E string that much anyway. So that's the B minor bar chord. So the pinky goes on the 4th fret on the G string, the middle finger on the 3rd fret on the B string, and then you bar the 2nd fret. A is just mute the low E string. You play the open A. You can mute the low E maybe with your thumb, or just remember to avoid it when you strum the A chord. So basically, the way I like to grab an A is to sandwich my fingers. So you have the third finger, you put the middle finger kind of on top of it, and the pointer kind of on top of that. And you try to get them all on the second fret, like this. So pointer finger goes on the E string second fret, middle on the G string second fret, and third finger on the B string second fret. Next is the D sus 2. So the pointer plays the second fret on the G string. Third finger goes on the third fret on the B, and you leave the high E string open. And you probably don't strum the low E or the low A. The D chord is, you just keep the same shape as the D sus 2 and put the middle finger down on the second fret on the high E. D sus 4, you put the pinky down on the third fret on the high E string. And once again, I'm not strumming these two low strings. Nasty. Next chord in the song is a G. I think Jeffrey's strumming this kind of G, the studio G, the real musician G, which is just to the middle finger plays the third fret on the low E string. Your middle finger skin mutes the A string. And then the third finger plays the third fret on the B string. Pinky plays underneath that on the high E string, the third fret. So, okay, G over A. The thumb mutes the low E, and then you just leave these bottom parts of G here, and you just strum all the strings except the low E. So the purpose of that chord is really for the low A to come out. So you get the G over B is the next chord we see. The pointer plays the second fret on the low A string, and you probably use the top of that finger to mute the low E. Next chord is an E major. Okay. Low E. It rings open. The middle finger plays the second fret on the A string. The third finger is underneath that, playing a second fret on the D. And then the pointer plays the first fret on the G string. So E sus 4, the pinky just comes down on the G string on the second fret. Next, we'll talk about how to play the really basic avoiding bar chords version of this chord progression on the with the capo on the seventh fret. So, get my capo. Put it on the 7th fret. Okay, the first chord is E minor. You would pretend that the capo is fret 0. You pretend this fret after the capo is fret 1. This is fret 2, and this would be fret 3. So you put your second finger on pretend fret 2 on the low A string, and the third finger underneath that, also on the second fret, but on the D string. And you strum all the strings. So that's E minor. the next chord we have is a D. So you put your pointer finger on pretend fret 2 on the G string. You put your middle finger on pretend fret 2 on the high E string. And your third finger comes in on the third fret on the B string. Like this. That's D. The next chord is a G over A. So basically you put your third finger on the pretend third fret on the B string, your fourth finger on the pretend third fret on the high E. And you, maybe your thumb can come up here and mute the low E. And you just strum all the other strings. Alright, G over B is put your pointer finger down on the pretend second fret on the low A string and use this skin to mute the low E. And then we'll call this a G sus 4. Probably isn't actually a G sus 4, but for this song, for like an easy way to do it, it works. You would just put your second finger on the third fret on the A string and use the top of the skin to mute the E, the low E, and then this whole time we have these notes down from the G chord, so. Next chord we see is a C chord. Okay, so the first finger on the second fret, the first fret on the second string on the B string, the middle finger plays the D string, second fret, and the third finger plays the low A string, third fret. But what's really fun about this song is the C sus 2 chord. You just lift your middle finger up and you get that low D string. Or middle D string. You just let the D string ring out. So. Okay. Next is an A. Your pointer finger plays the second fret on the D string, second finger plays the second fret on the G string, third finger plays the second fret on the B, and you probably avoid strumming the low E. So A sus 4, just leave this A chord how it is, and you just add the pinky down onto the third fret on the B string. So I was thinking the best way to start learning this song is to figure out the common strumming pattern that just runs throughout the whole song. There are variations, just like there are basic chords, but he embellishes those basic chords with the strumming. There is a basic strumming pattern that he keeps repeating, but he does embellish on it. But you can still have fun just by trying to first get the basic strumming pattern, and then you figure out how to improvise within that groove, and that's just a lot of fun. That's music, though. That's fun. So the basic strumming pattern that's irreducible for this song is down, up, down, up, down, down, up, down, up, down, down, up. Here it is again, slower. Down, up, down, up, down, down, up, down, up, down, down, up. And there are accents. There are two accents. So down, up, down, up, down, down, up, down, up, down, down, up. Here it is with the B minor chord. What Jeffrey Gaines does a lot is on that first loud accent, he actually mutes the strings. So down, up, up, down, down, up. If you click the Dropbox link in the description of this video, you will be taken to a big file, and I will have that strumming pattern written down. So you apply the basic rhythm to the B minor chord, and then the A chord, and then we'll have to talk about what he's doing during the D chord when he uses these embellishments. So you go down, up. So it's very important that X in the strumming chart just means a muted downstroke, which it's accomplished by lifting your fingers up and not squeezing the B minor chord so that your fingers touch the strings, therefore just muting the chord. So you go, so down, up, pop, up, down, down, up, down, up. And that's what you do on the B minor chord. Then for the A chord that's next, it's just down, down, up. So when you put it all together, next we get to the best part of the intro, the D sus 2 changing to D sus 4 back to D. It involves being able and practicing a D sus 2 chord, being able to hammer the middle finger down onto a regular D chord, which means basically the open E string, and using your second finger to hit this F sharp, the second fret on the high E string, but with a D chord behind it. So there was a good one. Then being able to strum a D sus 4 and pull off the pinky to the middle finger. So it looks like really like this. All under a D chord. That would be the first thing to practice. And we're going to apply all of that to the basic groove. So and actually, this is an example of where some things about it are going to sound like the basic groove, but it is a deviation. So following the strumming chart, you grab D sus 2 and you go down, down, up, down. And then you hammer onto the D chord. So down, down, up, down, hammer. And right after you hammer that middle finger note, you would strum the D chord. So it goes on D sus 2, down, down, up, down, hammer, strum. So when you're practicing, if this is like totally new to you, you've got to just practice that over and over before moving on for a while. So the next half of that measure is to strum a D sus 4 strum down and up. So on D7-4, just down, up. And right after that, you can see the two X's, which those are going to be down and up, but they're going to be mutes. And you would just slightly lift your fingers off of the G, B, and E strings, but to where you're still touching them. And you would aim your right hand strum. You would aim at just those strings so that you get the mute sound. So it goes down, up, down, up. But the last two are muted. So, like that. Okay, you can see my middle finger comes in because I heard the open D string sounding a little bit, so my middle finger came in and muted that D string. So, a little sloppy, but there we go. The next, last part of that really long to talk about measure, it's to strum the D7-4 and immediately after pull off to a normal D chord, and then do the mute sound again. Down, up, mute. This time with a regular D chord, and the same thing where you just slightly touch those fingers. So, so we get. And I guess, you know, I'm watching myself in the camera, and I saw my pinky came in and added additional muting powers for just a really sturdy mute. So that whole measure altogether is on a D7-2, down, down, up, down, hammer to D, strum down, grab a D7-4 and go down, up, mute, mute. And then D7-4, pull off to D, mute, mute. But it has to all flow together, so now I'll just try to play it without saying anything. So, next we have the verse groove, which is almost the same as the intro in that it's the same chord progression. And for the second half of the verse, during the D chord, he does do all of the embellishments. But the first half of the verse, he does not do the sus4, the D7-4 embellishment. He stays on the sus2. So he does the sus2. So once you hammer onto the D chord, he doesn't involve the pinky the first half of the verse. Let me just play through the verse slowly, following the strumming chart. So okay, and he repeats that several times. Halfway through the verse, he goes back to exactly like the intro, adding in the sus4 to the D chord. He throws in a G chord, and actually, just like for the D chord, he embellishes it with D7-2 and D7-4 and things like that. He's doing the same thing with the G chord. By in the bass, he adds an A bass note. He plays the open A string, and he hammers on to the A string, second fret, for a G over B kind of chord. So it's like down, down, up, down on the a G over A, hammer onto G over B and strum. Down, down, up, down, up, hammer down. Thankfully, that is the same exact strumming and syncopation with the embellishments. That's the same exact thing as what happened in the D chord in the intro. So, basically, it's nothing new. It's just replacing the D chord with the G chord and doing the embellishment rhythm. Next, we get to the pre-chorus, which is, again, very similar to everything we've seen before, except it's maybe a little more simple. It's on the A chord. Down, down, up, mute, up, down, down, up, down, up, down, down, up. Hopefully you can see that that's just the same groove as what we've been doing, except it's just nothing going on with the left hand, really. And it's all on the A. And then he gets to the G chord, and he's going to add these embellishments. You know, the G over A and the G over B. So we'll take a look at that. So down on G, so down, down, up, down, hammer, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, something like that. And with the chords, it's G, down, up, G over A, hammer to G over B, strum down, up, down, up, down, up, down. So most of the pre-chorus goes on like that, so I'll connect the two chords together. So down, down, up, up, down, down, up, down, up, down, down, up, down, down, up, down, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, down, up. Then we get to the ending of the pre-chorus, which is where he basically hangs on the G chord and continues to do the G over A to G over B embellishment. So it's down, down, up, down, up, hammer down, up, down, up, down. So down, down, up, down, down, up. Okay, and he does that four times before moving on to the chorus. And guess what? The chorus groove is, it's all the same stuff, just with two different chords. So you go to an E major chord and you apply the basic strumming pattern. Down, down, up, mute, up, down, down, up, down, up, down, down, up. For the mute, I just, in addition to lifting my fingers up instead of pressing really hard, I lift them up to just touch the strings, but I also use my pinky just for even more protection. And then we'll change to the D sus 2. And that's just the same exact strums as every other time in the verse and the intro, where you strum down on D sus 2, down, down, up, down, hammer, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up. So that's all the same. Sometimes he throws in the D sus 4 in the chorus. But then he gets to the chorus ending. The chorus ending is really nice. It's a E to E sus 4. Down, down, up, down, up, down. Up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down. So, down, down, up, down, up, down. Up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down. Down, up, down, up, down. Up, down, up, down, up, down, up. Okay, so this point in the song, there is no new material necessarily as far as chords. There's only dynamics, which means he strums really soft in verse 2 and in chorus 2, he's strumming really soft. So what I figured out for that is to pretty much just do all the same strums, but you kind of do them by palm muting, using your palm, and lightly touching the bridge. Here's an E chord, for example. Listen to what happens when I slightly palm mute that E chord. Okay, during the course of grooving, I'll sometimes create like a pop by maybe upstroking without the palm mute. So, you can see my palm lifting up off. So, whenever you see the accent marks in the strumming chart, if you're grooving quietly, you could come up off of the bridge and apply a down or an upstroke. Alright, thank you for watching this super long video. If you made it through all the way to the end, that probably means you really like this song, and I hope that I've helped you to learn how to play it. And if you have any questions, please leave a comment or send an email. And don't forget about the Dropbox link in the description below the video. It's got free material like charts, chord charts, song charts, just for this song.